The other video shows data with small sample size that results to rejecting the null hypothesis when doing the test of significance of correlation coefficient. Now let's examine another example of data in small sample size, but this time using Excel data analysis tool. Also, we will discuss about two methods in testing the significance of correlation coefficient. We obtain observation from a sample of 6 companies. Let's compute correlation coefficient using Excel CoREL function. We get a correlation coefficient of 0.704025, which suggests a strong linear relationship between X and Y.
Let's create a scatter plot showing also the regression line and regression equation. The regression equation is y is equal to 0.2425x plus 1.838. Can we use this regression line from sample data to model the relationship of two variables in the population?
Our null hypothesis is the correlation in the population is equal to zero, while our alternative hypothesis is the correlation in the population is not equal to zero. Manual calculation results to t value of 1.98268. We will compare this t value with the critical value. To get the critical value, we will use the table of t distribution. Sample size is 6 minus 2 equals 4 degrees of freedom. We will use level of significance or alpha of 0.05. Judging from the null hypothesis, this is a two-tailed test. So we will divide 0.05 by 2. Under column 0.025, we get critical value of 2.776. We will reject the null hypothesis if t value is less than negative 2.776 or greater than positive 2.776, since t value of 1.98268 is less than positive 2.776 or more than negative 2.776. Then we cannot reject the null hypothesis that the correlation in the population is equal to zero, meaning there is no significant relationship between X and Y in the population, and we cannot use the regression line for prediction. The main point here is that larger sample correlation coefficient does not necessarily result to rejecting the null hypothesis. A smaller sample size needs more larger value of sample correlation coefficient to reject the null hypothesis.
The second part of this video is the use of data analysis tool in Excel. Go to data, then click data analysis. Since we don't have it, then we have to download it. Go to file, then click options. Excel options will pop up. Click add-ins, highlight analysis tool pack. Next to manage Excel add-ins, click go. Check analysis tool pack, then click OK. When you go to data tab, data analysis will appear. Click it, choose regression. Under Y input, select the values of Y including its level. Under X input, select the values of X including its level. Click the label box. Under output box, choose new workbook. Finally, click OK. Then a new Excel workbook is created showing the analysis. Adjust the column weight to see all the results properly. Let's put the two workbooks side by side. Multiple R is the same with our correlation coefficient of 0.704025 computed using CoREL function. Compare regression coefficients against the scatter plot. Both have the same y-intercept of 1.838 and slope of 0.2425. The manual Excel calculation and data analysis also show the same test statistic or t value of 1.98268. The third part of this video is presenting the two methods in making conclusion. The first method, which we already applied, is the use of critical values. Since the t-value of 1.982681 is less than the critical value of positive 2.776, then we cannot reject the null hypothesis. The second method is the use of p-value. The data analysis shows a p-value of 0.1184, the same amount with significance F. The decision rule is that p-value should be less than the significance level to reject the null hypothesis. If p-value is more than the significance level, then we cannot reject the null hypothesis. Since p-value of 0.1184 is greater than the significance level of 0.05, then we cannot reject the null hypothesis. Take note that the two methods will give the same results.